Lord bless my soul, but what's wrong with me? I'm itching like a man.
To start this Google drawing, you're going to need to grab an image. Go to Insert, Image. You can choose an image from the web or an image from your computer. Next, pull that image. Stretch it to fill the canvas as much as possible without distorting it. Next, change the canvas size to match your image by grabbing that bottom right corner where the little lines are and drag it over to match the exact size of your photo image before letting go. Now let's get that image out of the way because the work we're doing is going to be on the canvas. Drag it. You can use the arrow button or just drag it over to the left so you have the image to one side and the canvas you're working on the other side. Next up, let's start with a background color on our canvas, your choice. Right click, background, and then choose your color. Again, you know your color options. You can choose a gradient like I did here, or you could custom or do one solid color, it's up to you. Next up, let's start by creating the first largest shape for our portrait. You need to switch the tool. At the top where that little line is, I'm going to switch that using the drop-down menu to grab that polyline tool. When using the polyline tool, I recommend you zoom in on your work. It makes it easier because you have to click that button a bunch of times. I decided to start with the black shape of Elvis's shirt, so I'm going to click on my polyline tool, click, and then as you walk along, each time you change angles, click. It's leaving little points. Click, click, click as I change angles to get this black shape of his shirt. If you ever find that you click and all of a sudden it became a bold, thick line, you clicked too close together. That's where zooming in matters. It allows you to kind of make more defined shapes. I'm going to continue clicking along here until I complete an entire shape. So I'm going all the way around his shirt, all the way around to the edge of the picture. When I basically get back to where I started, it will all of a sudden turn light blue to create a complete shape.
You can shake an apple off an apple tree.
As soon as I completed that shape, it turned that light blue. I need to change that. I'm going to go to the paint bucket tool and change that color to whatever you want. For me, it was black. Once you've changed your color, don't forget to take the outline and turn it transparent. You don't want a big black outline. Next, because we lined up our pictures, all I did was use my arrow keys and I moved that shape over to my canvas. Continue tracing big shapes, making sure you're using that polyline tool. Zoom in if you're struggling and it's creating that thick line on you. I'm going to click around. I decided to go with his hair next. So as I click around here, I'm going to finish that shape. Once again, it will turn blue and I'm going to change the color and send it over to my canvas, placing it as correctly as I can. I like to start with my biggest shapes and work down to my smallest shapes, sort of layering in the smallest details near the end. Watch me work for a while. Remember, I'm speeding this video up, so you're seeing my work done very quickly. This assignment took me almost 2 hours. As you work through each shape, once again, don't forget to remove the outline by turning the outline transparent. And have fun with your colors. You can do all kinds of creative things, including using a gradient, using colors that maybe are not realistic, creating custom colors. The sky's the limit. So have fun with your color choices as you create your image. The next shape I chose to work on was just the big shape of his skin tone, his whole face, ear, neck, everything. So I'm going around here using my polyline tool. I'm going to turn it into a color gradient because I notice in general his skin has sort of a light area and a dark area. But after I complete that, I am going to start working in small little shapes to add in the shadows, the lips, the eyes, the white shiny spot on the eyes. The details could go on forever. Once you get this dragged into place, you'll notice it may not fit perfectly. You can double click on any shape you created and all the little purple dots show up. Those purple dots are every place you clicked on when you created the shape to begin with. You can tweak it. You can grab any of those dots and stretch in different directions to try to adjust your shapes. Notice as I continue to work through my shapes, I'm zooming in and out. I zoom in to create shapes. I zoom out to double check that I like how they look on my actual work of art and that they're placing correctly. So do that a lot. Zoom in, zoom out, check your work, then go make a shape, pull back, check your work.
You know I can be found sitting home all alone. If you can't come around, at least please tell the phone. Don't be cruel to who heart is true. Baby, if I made you mad for something I might have said, please don't forget my past.
Notice as I created these lips, I started with that big pink shape, and then I created smaller shapes to layer on top of it. As with all shapes in Google Drawing, if you need to change the layers, you can right-click them to move them forward or move them backward by using the order.
Don't stop the hanging of me. Don't make me feel this way. Come on over here and love me. You know what I want you to say. Don't be cruel to who a heart is true. Why should we be apart? I really love you, baby. Cross my heart. Let's walk up to the preacher and let's say I do. Then you'll know you'll have me, and I know that I'll have you. Don't be cruel to who a heart is true. I don't want no other love. Oh, baby, it's just you I'm thinking of. Don't be cruel to who a heart is true. Don't be cruel to who a heart is true. I don't want no other love. Oh, baby, it's still you I'm thinking of. Well, bless my soul, but what's wrong with me? I'm itching like a man on a fuzzy tree. My friends say I'm acting wild as a bug. I'm in love. I'm all shook up. Ooh, ooh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, my hands are shaky and my knees are weak. I can't seem to stand on my own two feet. Who do you think of when you have such luck? I'm in love. I'm all shook up. Ooh, ooh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, please don't ask me what's on my mind. I'm a little mixed up, but I feel fine when I'm near the girl that I love best. My heart beats so it scares me to death when she touches my hand. Oh, what a chill I got. Her lips are like a volcano that's hot. I'm proud to say that she's my buttercup. I'm in love. I'm all shook up. Ooh, ooh, yeah, yeah, yeah. My tongue gets tied when I try to speak. My insides shake like a leaf on a tree. There's only one cure for this body of mine. That's to have that girl and her love so fine. She touched my hand and what a chill I got. Her lips are like a volcano that's hot. I'm proud to say that she's my buttercup. I'm in love. I'm all shook up. Ooh, ooh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Ooh, ooh, yeah, yeah. I'm all shook up. You can shake an apple off an apple tree. Shake a shake a sugar, but you'll never shake me. No siree. I'm gonna stick like glue. Stick because I'm stuck on you. I'm gonna run my fingers through your long black hair. I squeeze you tighter than a grizzly bear. Yes, sirree, oh. I'm gonna stick like glue. Stick because I'm stuck on you.